Hi and welcome to the session. I am Purva and I will help you with the following question. Evaluate the definite integral, limit from 0 to pi x into tan x upon sec x plus tan x dx. Let us now begin with the solution. Let us denote this definite integral by I. So we have I is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi x tan x upon sec x plus tan x dx. This is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi x into, now we can write tan x as sin x upon cos x, by sec x can be written as 1 upon cos x, plus tan x can be written as sin x upon cos x dx. And we can write this as, this is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi x sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx. And we mark this as equation 1. Now we know that integral limit from 0 to a fx dx is equal to integral limit from 0 to a f of a minus x dx. So we can write this equation 1 as I is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi pi minus x into sine of pi minus x upon 1 plus sine of pi minus x dx. This is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi pi minus x into, now sine of 180 minus theta is equal to sine theta, so we get sine pi minus x is equal to sine x upon 1 plus sine x dx. And we mark this as equation 2. Now adding 1 and 2 we get 1 plus I is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi x sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx plus integral limit from 0 to pi pi minus x sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx. This implies 2i is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi x sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx plus integral limit from 0 to pi pi into sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx minus integral limit from 0 to pi x sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx. Now the first and the third term on the right hand side will cancel out, so we get 2i is equal to integral limit from 0 to pi pi into sin x upon 1 plus sin x dx. This is equal to pi integral limit from 0 to pi. Now adding and subtracting 1 in numerator we get 1 plus sin x minus 1 upon 1 plus sin x dx. And this is equal to pi integral limit from 0 to pi 1 plus sin x upon 1 plus sin x minus 1 upon 1 plus sin x dx. Right? Now here 1 plus sin x will cancel out in numerator and denominator. So we are left with, this is equal to pi integral limit from 0 to pi 1 minus 1 upon 1 plus sin x dx. We can write this as this is equal to pi integral limit from 0 to pi dx minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi 1 upon 1 plus sin x dx. This is equal to pi. Now integrating 1 we get x. So we have x and limit is from 0 to pi minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi. Now multiplying the numerator and denominator by 1 minus sin x we get 1 minus sin x upon 1 plus sin x into 1 minus sin x dx. This is equal to pi. Now putting the limits we get here pi minus 0 because upper limit is pi. So putting pi in place of x we get pi minus lower limit is 0. So putting 0 in place of x we get 0 minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi 1 minus sin x upon, now we know that a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. So we get 1 minus sin square x dx. Since a plus b into a minus b is equal to a square minus b square. This is equal to, now pi into pi is pi square, so we get pi square minus pi into 0 is 0 minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi 1 minus sin x upon, now we know that 1 minus sin square x is equal to cos square x, so we get cos square x in denominator dx. This is equal to pi square minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi. Now we can write 1 minus sin x upon cos square x as 1 upon cos square x minus sin x upon cos square x dx, and this is equal to pi square minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi. Now we can write 1 upon cos square x as sec square x minus sin x upon, now we can write cos square x as cos x into cos x, right, dx, and this is equal to pi square minus pi integral limit from 0 to pi sec square x minus, now sin x upon cos x is equal to tan x, so we get tan x into, and 1 upon cos x is equal to sec x, so we get sec x dx. This is equal to pi square minus pi into, now integral of sec square x is equal to tan x, so we get tan x minus, and integral of tan x into sec x is equal to sec x, so we get sec x, and limit is from 0 to pi. This is equal to pi square minus pi into, now putting the limits we get tan pi minus sec pi minus tan 0 minus sec 0. Because putting upper limit pi in place of x we get tan pi minus sec pi minus, and putting lower limit 0 we get tan 0 minus sec 0. This is equal to pi square minus pi into, now we know that tan pi is equal to 0, so we get 0 minus, and sec pi is equal to minus 1, so we get minus 1 minus, tan 0 again is 0, so we get 0 minus, and sec 0 is equal to 1. So we get 1. This is equal to pi square minus pi into, now minus into minus will become plus, so we get plus 1. And here again minus into minus will become plus, so we get plus 1. And this is equal to pi square minus 1 plus 1 is 2, so 2 into pi is 2 pi. So we have 2i is equal to, now taking out pi common we get pi into pi minus 2. And this implies I is equal to pi by 2 into pi minus 2. So we get I is equal to pi by 2 into pi minus 2. Thus, we write our answer as pi by 2 into pi minus 2. Hope you have understood the solution. Take care and bye.